Live from the Xfinity Studios at WVON. We're your original social media. You're listening to Art Chat Daddy Sims on the Talk of Chicago, 1690 WVON.
p.m. right here on the Talk of Chicago, 1690 a.m. WVON. You're listening to Real Talk, Real People. I am your host, Chat Daddy, back for another evening of your favorite magazine show. Where did the rain come from? I just looked out this window and almost passed out. The devil beating that wife again. You're listening to your favorite happy hour on the radio. You know it's happy hour, so you should have your favorite beverage. We don't care what it is. And if that's the case, put as much sugary stuff in your drink tonight before tomorrow. You won't have any of it. If you're at work, continue to do enough work that you're able to keep your job, but keep listening to Real Talk, Real People. So it's August 1st, which means that is the official kickoff of the back-to-school season. And I had never heard of this term before, summer melt. And when I was pitched the story, I read it. I thought it was a great idea. And there's a wonderful program here in Chicago, and if I'm not mistaken, across the country, that helps young people who may really be on the fence of not knowing what they want to do with themselves after summer is over. They've graduated from high school, and it's time for them to do something else. And a lot of our young people get in trouble because they don't know where to go get help. So I'm so honored to welcome to the show this evening Mr. William Collins. He's the Managing Director of School Partnership for OneGoal. Good evening, sir,
and welcome
to the show. How are you?
Thank you for having us. I'm really glad to be here.
It's a pleasure to have you here.
Thank you.
So do me a favor. First of all, tell me all about OneGoal, and then I want to find out what summer melt is. I thought summer melt was, you know, we stay out in the sun too long, our deodorant is gone, all that. But no, it has a much bigger meaning than that.
Yes,
it does. All right.
Glad to be here. Thanks so much for having us. And really glad to tell you a little bit more about an organization that I work for, and it's very dear to my heart.
Mm-hmm.
So OneGoal is a national organization that works to close the college degree divide in our lifetime.
Okay.
We really believe that we can do that. And that divide exists between students from low-income communities and high-income communities.
Okay.
And so just to give you some data to go along with
that. Sure, absolutely. Please do.
Only 22% of students from low-income communities earn a college degree compared to 67% of their peers from high-income areas.
And I believe that. I really do. I'm glad to know what the exact numbers are, because you would believe that. A lot of times when young people live in economically deprived areas, they're just trying to survive day to day.
Yes.
And God forbid you're trying to get, you know, a trunk full of things to be able to go to a school. You need to be able to have money to survive and live. And you may have a situation where you're doing something to help the family, and so I can understand that. And there probably needs to be more young people from our economically deprived areas going off to school.
Absolutely.
So, yes.
Absolutely. And here's the magic to our program. Here's why we really think that within our lifetime we can close that college degree divide. OneGoal uniquely focuses on three important years of a student's development towards the college transition.
Okay.
And so we start working with students in their junior year of high school.
Oh, good.
We support them in their senior year of high school.
Mm-hmm.
But what makes our program so unique is that we also support those same students during their freshman year of college.
Oh, you do?
Yes. So we want to make sure that we see them through to day one of sophomore year.
Okay. So we're actually talking to somebody that may be going into their junior year with this, not necessarily knowing exactly what they want to do, where they might see themselves in the future.
Yes.
And you're grooming and training these young people to think the end goal, which is that degree.
The end goal is the degree.
And so I think that's so amazing.
We truly believe that the work that we're doing at OneGoal is making a difference. And so we work closely with high schools in low-income communities, much like the ones we see around Chicago,
mm-hmm.
To identify an amazing teacher that is already in that building. So, Art, I really want you to think back to high school and think about one teacher
mm-hmm.
that you really had a great experience with. That teacher was like a mentor to you. That teacher really sort of pushed you through and just was a coach and an advocate for your work.
Okay.
So imagine if that person served as a guide to help you get through college. And so the magic of our program is that we equip teachers like the ones I just mentioned
mm-hmm.
with a robust curriculum,
mm-hmm.
training, coaching, and tons of resources to implement our college success model starting that junior year of high school
mm-hmm.
with a group of students who, from an academic standpoint, they're probably middle of the road. So between a 2.0 and a 2.5 GPA with their standardized test scores, not really competitive. And so that combination
mm-hmm.
of factors really limits the amount of high-quality college institutions that those students can access.
So with this curriculum or this program of you trying to help these young people, I'm sure reading is probably very much a part of that curriculum.
Yes.
I'm sure mathematical and with everybody going into STEM and that type of thing. So how does that work with the educational component of it?
Absolutely. So we focus on two main areas. And so one is academic skills. And so what we really start to work with those students in their junior years to get them to understand that if you can get that GPA up, if you can work on test preparation to get that standardized test score up,
mm-hmm.
you will increase your college options if you can get those things up as high as possible. And so we really try to start working on those mindsets to get the students to believe that if I do these things, I can and I will go to college.
Nice.
We also work on non-cognitive skills because we really believe that if students start to advocate for themselves and have agency and know how to speak up for themselves, those are all skills that you know are really important.
That's true.
From childhood to adulthood.
That's very, very true. So how is a student recruited for this program? How does it all work?
Yeah. So let me tell you why our program is working, and I'll tell you how a student would get in. So right now our results really show that what we believe and what we're doing is working. 82% of OneGoal students graduate high school and enroll in college. And right now, 78% of those students are persisting or have completed their college degree.
Mm-hmm.
And so if a student is interested in OneGoal, one thing I would recommend if you're listening out there.
Oh, they listening. Trust and believe. They're listening.
It's just to go to our website.
Mm-hmm.
OneGoalGraduation.org is our website.
Mm-hmm.
And there you can find an interactive map that will show you all of the high schools and within the city of Chicago that we're in. And if you're interested, you can reach out to us there. You can also reach out to us on your favorite social media platforms, Facebook or Instagram, and we will certainly get back to you. But right now in Chicago, we are in nearly 80 high schools.
And really?
It's really exciting.
All over the city.
Yeah.
Wow, interesting. So what made you want to be a part of OneGoal? You know, here you are, African-American brother, with a great position.
Yeah.
Obviously, you have a compassion for our young people. So what drove you to want to be a part of OneGoal?
So I taught in CPS for 6 years. I was a high school teacher, and that was some of the best work I ever did. And one of the things that I love about that work is the students saw and heard from me how important a college degree was to my life.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a native Chicagoan, grew up on the south side of the city, product of a single parent home, and my mother was an educator with Chicago Public Schools for many, many years. Mm-hmm. And so growing up, I was always told that college is the key. Education is the key to unlock your future. And so after I got in that classroom and I really saw the impact that I was having on students, I really wanted to impact more students. And mm-hmm. so right now in Chicago, we're actually serving 5,000 students across the city.
Wow.
And across the country, we're serving around 9,300 students. And mm-hmm. so when I found OneGoal and saw how amazing this program was and the unique ways that they were working with students, I said, I have to work for them. And so I sort of said to God, like, please bring OneGoal into my life after I heard a presentation. And literally 3 months later, I got a call, and I am just beginning my third year on staff.
Very nice. And that's a story that people need to hear, that you are from the South Side of Chicago.
Yes.
Your backstory and just how important it is, you know, to do all the right things and continue to move forward. And now you're pouring back into our young people, which I think is just amazing.
Absolutely.
Really is. All right. So when we come back from break, we're actually going to talk to one of the students.
Yes.
You know, you can give all a lot of data you want, but I need to hear directly from a student of how wonderful and great this program is, and let's see if she'll say the same thing.
She's awesome.
Okay, we'll find out, and then we definitely will give how they can get connected and involved again, because I think it's very important.
Absolutely.
All right, my pleasure. We're talking to the wonderful people from OneGoal, and they're here to talk to juniors in high school, possibly even maybe, you know, can we squeeze a lazy senior in there? Well, they can't be lazy because they got to be on top of it. Well, okay, look, she like, yeah, okay, I can't wait to hear the student story. That's where I get the real dirt right there. Yes, you're listening to the Tuesday night edition of Real Talk, Real People. We'll be back in just a moment. Anyone after the hour, right here on the Talk of Chicago, 1690 AM, WVON. You're listening to Real Talk, Real People. I'm your host, Chat Daddy, back for another evening of your favorite magazine show here at VON, where we talk about a little bit of this and a whole lot of that. But most importantly, we hope that each and every night you are relaxing, relating, and releasing whatever that stress and drama from your day. We ask that you let it go. And if you're in your car driving, no drinking of alcohol and driving, you know that's against the law. And if you're at work, continue to do enough work that you're able to keep your job, but keep listening to Real Talk, Real People. Don't forget to go out and get your sugary beverage to go with your favorite beverage to listen to Chat Daddy tomorrow night. I don't want everybody grumpy and upset because you can't have your, as grandma and them used to say, cola and rum tomorrow night with a fresh piece of lime in it. No, I want y'all to have everything you need and want because you're a great listening audience. So I'm here with the wonderful people of an amazing program that helps high school juniors and seniors to actually do something with their life, commit themselves to a great program. The program is OneGoal. It's based here. It's here in Chicago, but it's a national program as well, too, in over 80 high schools here in the Chicagoland area. I have Mr. William Collins, who's the managing director of school partnerships, and he brought a wonderful student with him tonight. Her name is Leslie Ruiz. I got that right. I'm looking at it, and it was a tongue twister. She's a fellow in the OneGoal program, and it's so such a pleasure to have you here tonight. How are you? You're beautiful, too. How are you?
Thank you.
So what has this wonderful program done for you?
Well, it's actually done a lot. So let me just start off by saying before OneGoal, I was lost.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I didn't know.
Look, pour all your tea. I'm ready to hear it. Go right ahead. Pour all that tea. Yes.
So, yeah, I was just confused on whether I wanted to go to college. If I didn't, I am the first from my family. So
congratulations.
Thank you.
Very nice.
It was tough because I didn't know the process. I didn't know anything about college. Mm-hmm. But when my program director came and he was like, hey, you know, this is the program. And he explained it to me. I was like, what a great opportunity. Like, let's go for it. So he helped me out, and then I was able to learn everything within college, and I learned, you know, what's my best fit, you know, where do I fit in, and yeah.
So prior to this program, you were probably a dicey student, or were you holding your own in school, or, you know, how did that all work out? Because, of course, they made you the better student, and now you're headed off to school in 2 weeks.
Yeah, correct. So, I mean, academic-wise, I was okay. I wasn't the best. But joining OneGoal, they help you academically as well. Like, they give you something to look forward to. They motivate you, and they definitely support you, so... It was definitely beneficial for me to join.
Now, I heard not only have you benefit from this program, but what about your sister, I was told? Isn't it a story about your sister?
Oh, yeah. So being that I joined OneGoal and now she sees me going off to college, it's motivated her to also go back to school because she never finished school.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, now she's actually planning on going back.
Very nice. Oh, yeah. That's so beautiful. So now where are you headed off to school?
I'm actually going to Iowa Wesleyan University.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Are you excited?
Super excited.
Really? And you're the first in your family that will go off to college?
Yeah.
And what will you be majoring in?
Criminology.
Oh, really? So you're going to, like, catch these criminals and all that good thing, fingerprints and all that.
Yeah.
Very nice. So what would you say to somebody that's listening to tonight's show and they just don't know what they want to do? You know, they might be a good guy or good girl, but yet, you know, they just, like you said, clueless and lost. What advice would you want to give them?
I'd definitely tell them if OneGoal is partnered with their school, or not even if they're partnered, but if they need somebody, they can definitely reach out to OneGoal. Their staff is great. They're always there to support you and help you. And OneGoal is definitely a support system. So if it's there and it's available to you, definitely take advantage because in the long run, it'll help you.
Oh, very good. All right. Is there anybody you want to shout out since you're on the radio? Is this your first time ever on the radio?
Yes, it is.
You're doing a great job. Really, I'm almost thinking about having you come back as a co-host because you're very energetic, but you're leaving to go to school. So
yes.
That's a good thing. Anybody want to shout out tonight?
Yeah, you know, I actually want to shout out my program director. His name is Mr. Tuggle.
Mm-hmm.
Excuse me. And just because he's done a great job, and even throughout the process of going to college, I actually sort of like backed out right at the end, senior year, backed out. I was like, nope, I don't want to do it. But he spoke to me and he motivated me, and he definitely did a great job and told me, you know, there's no limit, so you got to keep going.
That's right. That's right. I'm so happy he did tell you that, because really the sky's the limit for you, young lady. And if you really put your mind to it, you have a great support system behind you.
Correct.
You're going to really make your family proud. And you did. You made history in your family, and that's so important. It really is. Anybody else you want to shout out?
And actually, the whole OneGoal, like the whole entire staff, everyone. They're really amazing and great people.
Okay, you better shout that family out too before they get you. You know what I'm saying? You do have to look. You got 2 more weeks of dealing with them, so at least say hey to mom and them or whoever.
And lastly, my parents—they're definitely a great support for me. And they've like kind of forced me to go to college. So.
That's nice. Yes, that's what that's all about. That's exactly what that's all about. So, William. What a beautiful success story.
Yes,
what a great
awesome.
Success story. I'm sure you have hundreds of other success stories
yes.
like this. So really, give my audience the lowdown on how they can get a young person involved in this. Because I think a lot of the situations that we have out here in these streets and all this, you know, young people wilding out is because they don't have any guidance in any direction. So let's get as many young people connected to this program as
Absolutely.
Possible.
Absolutely. Thank you so much. And so if you're interested in learning more about our program, visit our website at onegoalgraduation.org, and you can find tons of resources and information about how you can get involved. You can also, like I said earlier, look at our interactive map to see if OneGoal is in your school, and it will give you information on how to get connected. And one other thing I want to mention is that right now, because we're in the summer and many, many students like Leslie are headed off to college, we have a supplies drive happening right now. And so we have a link set up on our website where folks want to just support students from across the city of Chicago that are just needing a little bit more support and getting some supplies for college. There's a link on our website where folks can purchase Amazon gift cards for any college-bound student. And so you will also see a number of other ways you can get involved with our work. But again, our website is OneGoalGraduation.org. And please share our message. You can also find us on Facebook if you are on Facebook. One Goal is just one word, or Instagram as well.
Very good. Well, college-bound Leslie Ruiz, correct?
Correct.
All right. I wish you the absolute best. You're going to do well. I expect you to come back and give me an update next year.
Definitely.
On your first year of college. We'll kind of make this a little annual thing so I can check on your progress. And thank you for encouraging other young people to just let it go and move on and have a good life. And that's what that's all about.
Definitely. Thank you.
My pleasure. Absolutely. And the best of luck to you. And Mr. Collins,
yes,
great job.
Thank you. In closing,
anything else you want to say to these wonderful people?
One Goal is a movement, and we're trying to literally turn Chicago into the college degree attainment city. We believe that we can change the face of our city and the other amazing cities that we're a part of across this country. But again, look for One Goal in your school. We're in a lot of them, and we'd be glad to support students as they're on their journey to and through college.
Well, thank you both so very much. Great job. I'm very honored to have had you here tonight to talk about this, because progression is the key to our survival.
Yes.
We've got to be very progressive people at this point. We've got to love and accept and be progressive.
Yes, sir.
My pleasure. Thank you so very much. So listen, ladies and gentlemen, give it up for One Goal. Get them young people off that couch. Stop that summer melt. Move forward. Do what needs to be done. Needs to be done. Needs to be done. Needs to be done. Needs to be done.